You have come to ride with me one last time.
Yes, my lord.
I did not want your father and your uncle to leave, only because you would have gone with them. Had I known how much sorrow this would cause me, I would never have consented.
It's hard for me too, my lord.
At least you have promised to return.
When I've seen your letters safely dispatched to the Pope, and to the kings of France, England, and Spain, and been to my home, I'll try to keep my promise.
I know you will. But I will not be here to greet you. Something of you will remain behind in this land, though. As long as men have memory. People coming here in your name will need no safe conduct. You have proved yourself a friend, and they will be welcome as friends. Kaidu was right. We conquered the world on horseback and should rule it from horseback. But now I'm too old to climb into the saddle. I'm only half a Mongol. Too much blood has been spilled. Brothers fighting brothers. The gods are angry at us. Timur will inherit a crumbling empire. Everything I did was for Chingu. But what I gave him was not what he wanted. He believed in the dream that China would be united. It will be. One day. One day it would be. But that is going to be another time. Marco, help me. From the north, the cold-breathing Hanfeng will bring the scent of the Mongolian grassland and the neighing of its horses. Nostalgia will seize me, and I will think of you as of a faraway son. Take my hand, Marco. Remember, when a Mongol takes you by the hand, some of his spirit passes over to you.
you admit to having entered pagan places of worship?
And to having taken part in magic rites?
I've only reported what I saw, without adding or taking anything away. My eyes are one thing. My Christian conscience is another. As to the religions I've told you about, I've learned one thing. They're good or bad, according to the hearts of the men who practiced them.
Saint Paul did not hesitate to enter the temples of pagan deities in Greece and in Rome.
Do you dare to say that this Venetian is like the Holy Apostle?
I say, I've never felt as close to my God as after having known the religions of the world.
You wrote that Mr. Marco Polo had found the Garden of Eden.
I never said that.
Well, maybe I wrote it by mistake while you were talking about Badak Shan. We could cut it out.
Is it not true that you, Rustichello of Pisa, have written, as he dictated, of Oriental wives who lie with foreign men? With encouragement and approval of their husbands.
Mr. Polo said it was their custom, their way of honoring guests.
But every sailor in Pisa and Venice, and probably in Genoa too, tells the same stories.
The fact that sin is repeated in many lands and multiplied does not make it less abominable, nor less to be condemned in those who spread its stench or tolerate it. These tales are not for innocent ears.
Forgive me. I only wanted to say, reverend sirs, that his tales made me feel homesick, made me long for my wife. How lucky for me, I thought, to have married a woman who lives only for me all her life.
Your statements on the existence of groups or clusters of stars, which our astronomic science does not recognize, corrupt the harmonious order of creation, as it appears to us, faithful servants to God and his truth.
Similarly subversive are your descriptions of countries and people which you claim exist, where by certain knowledge there is nothing but howling darkness.
The learned Dr. Pietro de Abano has permission to speak.
No astronomic map that we possess includes the stars that this Venetian claims to have seen. Yet I have come to learn that Messer Polo's observations, unlikely as they seem, have recently been confirmed by other navigators and Arab astronomers.
Heresy, confirmed by infidels.
And not only by them. We have at long last been able to read. We do not yet have the privilege of knowing how to reproduce books with special machinery to print them, as your Chinese friends do. So we have to content ourselves with waiting for patient hands to transcribe copies one by one. We have at last been able to read the long report by the Franciscan monk Giovanni from Candicarpini on his travels beyond the borders of Mongolia, where it was certain knowledge that nothing but darkness exists.
If your life in Mongolia was so luxurious and noble, why did you wish to return to Venice?
My father and uncle wanted to see their home again before they died. I believe it was God's will that we returned, to show man the road to new knowledge.
So you continue to claim that everything in a book is true? Men flying? A magical powder that explodes in the air and makes fountains of light fall from the sky?
As God is my witness, I've told less than half of all that I've seen.
I beg you to allow me to confess, publicly as the early Christians used to do.
This man is guilty. He encouraged me to escape from prison. More. He gave me a key to help me escape. More than that, with his tales, he tore down the walls of my cell and made me a free man. He fought and won against our oldest enemy. Ignorance. Thanks to Marco Polo, I've traveled far away from here, seen new places, times yet to come. He not only traveled from here to China, but from the past into the future. Here I am, in your custody, and yet unchained. A new faith is kindled in me. A new faith in man, a creature born to overcome frontiers and prejudice. He made me see that violence, hatred, suspicion are mere clouds that the light of knowledge soon dispels. Marco Polo freed me from fear. From his long journeys across lands known and unknown, he returned the champion of a new mankind.
Look at him.
Around him, if you let your hearts beat freely and your minds can open up to reason, you can see an aura of intelligence which sees far beyond simple facts, places, people. A light that should make us strong and patient, noble and civilized, and worthy to explore the new horizons of the world before us, and worthy to explore the immense wonders of the stars.
It is with some reservation that we reach our decision, Messer Polo. We find that you have touched on questions beyond your understanding and steered perilously close to false doctrines against which the Holy Mother Church must be constantly on her guard. We believe that you had no intention to sin. Therefore, we order you to meditate and revise your tales in accordance with what your conscience dictates. And may God have mercy on you and enlighten you. You are free to go.
What about me? Thank you.
Marco, enjoy your freedom in Venice.